and we want you to receive tonight in a little different manner. We want to be able to serve you at the same time, both the bread and the cup. And then we'll share those things, as I believe the Bible says that they did around the Lord's Supper that night. And so as our deacons pass out the elements of the Lord's Supper, let me read to you the scripture from that night in Matthew, the 26th chapter. It said, on the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, where do you want us to make preparation for you to eat the Passover meal? And he replied, go into the city to a certain man and tell him, the teacher says, my appointed time is near. I'm going to celebrate the Passover with my disciples at your home. And so the disciples did as Jesus had directed them and prepared the Passover. When evening came, Jesus was reclining at the table with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me. And they were very sad. And they began to say to him one after the other, surely not I, Lord. And Jesus replied, the one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. And the Son of Man will go just as it is written about him. But woe to that man who betrays the Son of Man. It would be better for him if he had not been born. Then Judas, the one who would betray him, said, surely not I, Rabbi. And Jesus answered, yes, it is you. And while they were eating, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat, this is my body. And then he took the cup, gave thanks, and offered it to them, saying, drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine from now on until that day when I drink it anew with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. As we prepare our hearts to receive the Lord's Supper, I want you to bow with me in prayer. And as you continue to receive the elements, of course, you keep your eyes open. God doesn't care whether or not your eyes are closed or open. He doesn't care whether or not you're on your knees or standing up or on a ladder, because God looks and listens to our hearts. He doesn't listen so much to our words as he listens to our hearts. So let's pray together now as we prepare our own hearts personally, individually, to be able to take place, to take part in the Lord's Supper, which launched Jesus Christ to face the cross. Let's pray together.